another lovely episode of Mixed Rated. I'm Olivia Speranza.
And I'm Joey Gila, but you don't care.
They do. Coming up on today's show, raise your Hello Kitty pens with pride because Trish Kuyong checks in from the 50th anniversary of Sanrio.
And with WonderCon just days away, we sit down with cosplay ultra hottie Linda Lay, both in and out of costume time.
And finally, the ladies of Foreplay stop by to get undiscovered.
Calm down, fellas. You know what? I just want to share something with you guys. I've been a big fan of music all my life, especially the club hits. Getting my groove on to New Edition. Yeah. Jodeci, who yeah? And Boys to Men.
Yeah.
Who? Yeah. But what the hell is this? I hate that song. What the hell was that? That was like the Caucasian T-Pain. Oh my God. I'd rather hear Manny Pacquiao sing.
Well, Joey, it just goes to show you that you actually don't need to be talented to be famous. All you need to be is white and rich.
It's like watching Glee with Down syndrome.
Ooh, that's harsh. Well, look, we can all agree here that the biggest crime of all is that Rebecca Black's parents had sex and had her in the first place.
Yeah. Calm down, the crazy tiger. You have offended the rich white people. Let me mail you out with some Hello Kitty. Oh.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Trish, and I'm where every girl wants to be. And maybe some guys. I'm in Santa Monica, California, where Sanrio turns 50. Look at all this craziness going on. I thought it was gonna be packed, but this is way more than packed. Absolutely nuts, you guys. People are lined up for golf, popcorn, games, spin the cotton candy, what have you. Anything and everything here is Sanrio. But enough of my talking. We gotta go check it out, so let's.
Each venue consists of different activities that not only will kids enjoy, adults can enjoy as well.
You know, it's just a pop culture. You know, the following from young girls to adults, you know, people even older than me that still love Hello Kitty. And then it's just good to see like the whole vibe and the energy coming to events like this. It's just so inspirational.
Why are you here today?
Because we love Hello Kitty and we just like her. Yeah.
I'm here pretty much Sanrio.
Just to shop and see all the Hello Kitty stuff. I don't know, some of the art caught my eye, so I'm definitely gonna look it up when I leave.
I know a lot about the art that's being displayed, and some of the artists I do know personally, so it's my way of expressing how much I like.
Just being in this surrounding is making me super. I came here yesterday for opening night, and it was a blast. I had so much.
Character of all time.
Oh, my favorite is Pachaco.
Well, my favorite is My Melody. I love her.
Yeah, that's what's up. This is how I roll. So when did you fall in love with your favorite Sanrio character?
I basically grew up with it. You know, my mom, she introduced it to me with the dolls, the clothes. I don't know, it kind of really attached to me because that and Barbie, I'm just so in love with it.
Second, third grade. So as soon as I got my allowance money, right next to my elementary school, there's a Sanrio store. Every day after school, my girlfriends and I would come back on time so our parents could pick us up.
just to purchase Hello Kitty products?
Well, I was brought up with Hello Kitty. We always had Hello Kitty sweaters and dolls ever since we were little toddlers.
It's an obsessive, compulsive thing. Now, everything I see Hello Kitty, I want to buy it. I'm just in love with it, and I definitely am going to pass it on when I have kids. I think I'm going to be that crazy mom buying all kinds of stuff and be like, oh my God, too much. But I can't help it.
What do you still carry in your bag right now that's Hello Kitty?
I have a wallet, and it's together with the Toki Doki.
I have a planner,
Sanrio planner.
A Hello Kitty ring, and then I also have my Hello Kitty wallet.
That's official, guys. It's a wrap for us. We're done here, but the people are still coming in. The party's still going on. Thank you to Sanrio for having me. We truly appreciate it, and we hope you guys at home enjoyed it. So back to you at the studio.
Man, I didn't realize that there were going to be so many potty mouths at a Sanrio event.
For reals, that is so wrong. It's like mother, son of a, shame on you, Trish. Anyways, for those of you who want to watch the uncensored version of this segment, be sure to check it out on our Facebook page.
All right, you guys. Now, Joey has a new dance DVD that surprisingly is selling out all over the place. And you know what, Joey? I've got to hand it to you. I really didn't think that this was going to work out. Take a look.
Hey, I'm comedian, TV personality, and hairdresser, Joey Gila. What makes me so amazing, so fabulous? My many dances. Dance. Dance.
Dance.
And now, you can dance just like me with Getting Joey With It. Attend this Blu-ray set that will teach you step by step of all the hottest moves that will get you the ladies, the fellas,
aye,
the bisexuals.
Why are you filming me?
Dance. And it all starts with the gay robot. And one of the hottest dances, if you don't have a dentist plan, is gum disease. I do the gum disease, I do the gum disease. And don't forget about the shoplift. Getting Joey With It is the greatest dance instructional video of all time. But don't take my word for it.
When I was younger, I suffered from extreme shyness, eczema, Asperger's, acne, and even a penis. But now that I'm getting Joey With It, I'm a real girl. Thanks, Joey.
Thank you, Hermaphrodite. Now, I bet you'd expect to pay a steep price of $200 for this outstanding set, and you'd be wrong. You'd be getting Joey With It for the low, low price of $199.99, plus shipping and handling. Now don't delay, it's time for you to be Getting Joey With It.
Getting Joey With It is not a real product, and if it was, it would probably kill your social life. And if you were planning to buy a dance instructional DVD, you probably didn't have a social life anyways. So turn off the TV and get a life, you losers.
Joey, that was pretty amazing.
See, I told you, you didn't think I got it. Check this out.
I didn't think so.
It's selling all over. You guys probably seen it. Garage sales, flea markets. But you know what? Olivia, you're in luck. Well, I'm going to teach you one dance. Absolutely free, y'all.
For free? Oh, my God, Joey.
All right,
I'm
all right,
so
right.
Lucky.
It's not even on a DVD yet. It's called The Asthma. Are you ready?
This is not on the DVD.
Yeah. Are you guys ready? Make some noise for The Asthma. All right, here we go. At home, at home. One hand, you got the pump. Ready? It's two pumps and wheeze. Ready? Pump, 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 pump.
Okay, pump, okay, wait.
Pump. There you go.
Pump, pump. All right. More pump. Teeth, right?
Yeah, yeah, more teeth. Teeth. Let out.
Like the donkey.
Yeah, there you okay, go. Like okay, donkey. Right. Ready? Ready? Right. One more attitude right here.
All right, all right.
Pump, 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 pump,
there's not pump, conviction pump, here. All right, you guys, we've got more mixed rage, including a performance by Foreplay, but up next, Linda Lay.
Respond to my boner. Damn you, autocorrect.
Oh,
missed a dance earlier. It's called asthma. Pump, pump.
All right, don't dry
pump,
your teeth.
Pump.
Don't dry your mouth. Come on.
Welcome back to Mixed Reddit, everybody. Make some noise. Come on.
Make some noise, guys. All right, ChicagoNow.com released 50 ridiculously bad cosplay attempts. We're going to take a look at our top three.
Oh.
He's got the sword and the dagger.
That's a Smurf tampon. Oh!
Wow.
That's Lindsay Lohan at 80.
Oh, that's wrong.
That's Hulk Hogan's daughter.
That's Gary Busey's wife.
Oh! Damn. This is a braces commercial in Oakland.
We're going to hell.
Oh,
it's special.
He needs prescription braces. Yo, this young lady makes dressing up at Comic-Con hotter than a Victoria's Secret catalog.
That's pretty hot. That's pretty hot. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Linda Lay.
My name is Linda Lee, but people call me Vampy, and I currently reside in San Jose, California. Vampy? I actually got that nickname while I was growing up because I always read a lot of vampire novels and a lot of dark stuff, and I was always pale. So it was easy for them to call me Little Miss Vampy, so it stuck with me for a couple years now. When I was younger, it was hard because I actually didn't have a lot of friends that were girls. I always grew up with like a lot of guy toys. First Nintendo, Castlevania, He-Man, wrestling was one of my favorite things too. I had two brothers and one was heavily into anime and it was pretty new in America. We used to go to this place and every week they would have new anime from Japan. So we would come there every week and buy the new anime, which was like Akira, Ranma, which is my favorite too. So that's how it came about. And then I guess like I fell in love.
With a little luck and lots of imagination, Linda was able to turn her love for anime into a full-fledged career.
There are quite a bit of jobs that I've always wanted to do, but then I thought I never could do, which is kind of weird. Modeling, I mean, I was so scared of the camera, so I do that full-time now, which is kind of weird because it's like, I would never assume that like when I would grow up being as shy as I was to be in front of a camera. And of course, doing comics right now, I'm working with quite a bit of people doing comics. I mean, in the beginning it was kind of awkward because I would go into the conventions and having people know my name was kind of weird still. I guess geeking out every day is my normal thing and people like it. You know, I just spilled out there and then I got this growing number of people telling me that they enjoyed my work and going to the conventions, I got to meet them and that was really cool because everyone actually is a real geek and they're geeking out with each other and it's just nothing that I've ever experienced before, so it's nothing fake.
Though Vampy's not the first person to get immersed in the world of cosplay, she definitely took the lifestyle to a whole new level.
I think it's cool because it's like Halloween all the time for me because as a kid, you know, dressing weird, I didn't think it was weird at all. And now more people are doing it and it's like more easy, accessible to like do little photo shoots with people or like geeking out on the internet with people that you usually wouldn't think they're interested in it. I always see that if more people are doing it, it's more getting more aware, like awareness of like, yes, geeks have voices, you know?
And with that being said, we invited Linda to our studio for an exclusive mixed rated photo shoot to change your definition of the word geek.
The first outfit was Tifa from Final Fantasy VII, and that's Advent Children. If you guys watch Advent Children, that was the outfit that I got to wear, and I love Tifa. I mean, I know a lot of you guys are sick of Tifa, but I mean, come on, Tifa's awesome. Yeah, tried as hard as I could to pinpoint everything, even to my haircut that day, so hopefully it came out good, so yeah. Number two, well, White Phoenix. Of course, White Phoenix is, I guess like a lot of people liked it because it was not part of like what I was used to wearing, but I just love her because she's pretty badass. So Yeah, that was the second costume. So Juri, either you love her or you hate her. I love her because she's the first female that ever, like, is in Street Fighter that kicks ass, like, kicks major ass. Can I say ass? Okay, anyway, yeah, kicks major ass, and she's not sweet and cute and pretty, she just wants to own. I actually have a lot of old school anime cosplays coming up. I'm big into the nostalgia part of, like, anime and manga, so I'm working on a couple right now. Can't really give you too many details, but it's old school, so. Well, I do have a little tiny blog spot that I have online that I update quite frequently, and that's Vampy Bit Me, so it's www.vampy.me, so it's Vampy Bit Me.
Hey everyone, let's say thanks. Hope you guys enjoy.
I don't think I'll ever grow up. That's one of the things that I kind of take pride in myself, because I'm quite a dreamer and I will always live out whatever I think in my head, so yeah.
All right, guys, get ready, because we'll be back with our musical guest, fellas. Yeah!
Jared from Reno asks, I was thinking of buying a 3D TV. What do you think, Uncle Ronnie?
Well, Jared, I think those 3D TVs are a rooftop with a capital O. Nothing comes out of the screen at all. And those glasses are so expensive. And everything looks really dark. They all just suck. I wouldn't bother with any of those out there. Sushi me. Thank you, my kitty cat. But if you're really committed to seeing something jump out at you, your Uncle Ronnie can help you.
Don't hate, because I'm packing like dim sum.
Hi, Jared.
You guys, thanks for checking in. The moment you've all been waiting for.
Not again, please.
Yo. For those who don't remember, we asked you, our viewers, to come up with a caption for this beautiful, fine picture. Check it out.
Oh, that's so wrong.
No. Well, we thank you all for your submissions, but there can only be one winner of the Qbert DJ Hero 2 prize package. Can I get a drum roll? And the winner is John Paul Richard.
Right. Congrats to you, my brother. You are one sick man.
Yeah, you are.
Look at me all naked, smothered in gravy. But yo, to check out John Paul's and all the other captions for our contest, be sure to log onto our Facebook page.
All right, shut up, Joey. I had a chance to sit down and chat with our next undiscovered artist, and I must say, their name is just as tantalizing as their music. So without any further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's get to some foreplay.
Harlan Jewell, Charlie Reno, Trish Maxell, and Elle Jackson. A fierce quartet of sexy and talented ladies who make up the group, Foreplay.
Tell us the story of how Foreplay became.
Well, we were solo artists before, and they asked us to kind of join this cover band, and we met through there, and we were doing just kind of reviews as far as covering artists that we already know, and then we wanted to make our own music, so we ventured out and took it to the next level and just really became, I guess, a recording group.
Don't stop,
Our style is about electro, R&B, pop, and we use a lot of eclectic beats, which are influenced by Beyonce and Lady Gaga.
So pretty much if Lady Gaga and Beyonce had a baby, it would be like
us, Fourplay.
got it.
When we started, we were like, okay, how are we going to take this? What are we going to do in order to take it to the next level? And a mentor of ours, her name is Fatal Estrella. She's an international comedian. She gave us the name. And she's like, well, there's four of you, and it's a cute name, so.
Explain a live Fourplay show.
We love to give the Fourplay experience, meaning there's a lot of dancing, a lot of choreography, singing, interaction with the crowd. High energy, and
don't forget the head throw.
There's a lot of hair.
We do have a signature move too, which is a head throw.
5, 6, 7, 8, come on.
Okay, so the group won't be changing its name to Fourplay anytime soon, which is good because they have a lot more to focus on than adding a fifth wheel.
We're just trying to finish our album, our EP. We're putting it out, and we've been working with some really good producers, Good Sire, Creasel, and Jay Ricks, who is the producer of our carrier single, Dirty Little Secret. It's really cool. We're like four girls that just love to sing and dance and play on stage, so.
Here to perform their new hit single, Dirty Little Secret.
Ladies and gentlemen, the gorgeous ladies of Fourplay.
Good boy.
girls are hot.
They are.
Very
all
hot.
Of them.
Hey, you girls are naughty for play.
Oh.
Well, that's going to do it for us. And this episode of Ready Mix Rated.
Oh my God. All right, now to stay connected, be sure to follow us on the Twitter.
Also, check out all the latest news on Facebook, Tumblr page.
All right, you guys, thank you all for watching. I am Olivia Speranza.
See you next week. Say them, Tim, say them.
Say them goodbye, okay? Goodbye, good luck.